would be to St. Louis, Missouri, a bit cooler here in the city that hosted the 1904 Olympic Games. And tonight, the gateway to America's West is the final stop on the road to the Tokyo Olympics for America's gymnasts. Of course, the headliner in front of this crowd of nearly 21,000, the most ever at a U.S. gymnastics trials. So many here to see that woman, Simone Biles, 24 years old, four golds and a bronze at the Rio Olympics, looking even stronger competitively this year, and minutes away from beginning the final night of trials on vault, where she has redefined the sport. The competition for the women began on Friday, and after the four rotations Friday night, Simone Biles is on top. She'll be joined by three other women on the U.S. Olympic team. The expectation coming in tonight is that Sunny Lee and Jordan Chiles will be two of them. But as you see, it's a very tight race at 4, 5, and 6 there. There's also another individual berth that will play out. A lot of pressure and a lot on the line this evening. Hi, everybody. Mike Tirico, welcome inside the Dome at America's Center. A lot of anticipation here after an extra year of waiting. This is the last night of Olympic trials to earn a spot on Team USA in Tokyo. Over the last 3 weekends, we've gone across the country, seen breakout performances in swimming and track. And now one final opportunity for Simone Biles to put an exclamation point on her Olympic preparation. She is a champion, and to take us through the night, some champions in their own right. 1983 NCAA men's basketball champ Terry Gannon with Olympic champions Tim Daggett and Nasty Lucas. Terry.
Mike, thanks for the mention. I appreciate that little bonus here to kick off the night. And what a night. I mean, you guys know what it's all about. You've been in this position. You're trying to realize a dream. Make the Olympic team. Take me through, Nastia, what tonight is all about.
Well, you know, in my opinion, I think that this is the hardest team in the entire world to make, and one of the most exclusive clubs to be part of. When you are on that team, Olympic dreams are going to be made tonight, and unfortunately, some are going to be crushed.
Yeah, you know, I mean, basically, every single one of these young ladies, when they were 3, 5 years old, they have watched the Olympics happen. They've seen these stars develop, and it is everything to them. But it didn't just happen. They worked so hard and overcame so much to get to this point. It's going to be a celebration of gymnastics.
Tim, you think about how many thousands, hundreds of thousands, whatever it is, women and little girls out there competing in gymnastics in the United States. There'll be 6 names we'll be talking about at the end of tonight, and here's how it breaks down. What is at stake? 4 team spots that will compete in the team event at the Olympics. The top 2 here, they're locks to make that team. But then it comes down to a selection committee for the other 2 spots. The individual spots, Jade Carey has already wrapped one up, and then one more out there to be taken, to be earned tonight. So many names in the mix for that and the other 2 team spots. And at the Olympics, that team final, you'll have 4 members on the team, but 3 of them chosen. And then all 3 of the scores count towards the team total. So even more pressure because all 3 of those count. And when you start thinking about building a team, and jump in here, guys, with these names that we surmise will be there at the end, but then some question marks.
Well, yeah, absolutely. So there are question marks, and you look at this on vault and on floor. And where those question marks are, it's Sunny Lee, who is exceptional on the uneven bars and fantastic on beam, but her 2 weakest events are vault and floor.
Yeah, absolutely. There's no question. I mean, they could win the Olympics with 3 gymnasts. Let's just put that right out there. But if you want to say, where could you get a couple more tenths here and there, that position, there's a lot of people that are in the running for that. Obviously, Michaela Skinner, Jordan Chiles, Kayla Jacello, Grace McCollum, Leanne Wong. There are amazing athletes.
So you're talking about filling those team spots, and at least in part, based on your needs, where you may need that third person on floor or on vault, but that individual spot that is out there. Remember, Jade Carey has already qualified. That was the World Cup apparatus final. So she earned a spot. She came here. If she had finished in the top 2, you say she could take a team spot, but right now, that's not realistic. But those other names in the mix for that individual spot, as we get a look at the 5-time medalist at the Rio Olympics, 4 of them gold medals, and yes, the greatest of all time. That's our little bonus. We get to watch Simone Biles tonight. Yeah. And one of the big reasons that we've got 21,000 people here inside the Dome.
And, you know, these Olympic trials for her, it's really just kind of putting a check mark by this competition, because she is going to go to Tokyo no matter what. And not only go to Tokyo, but she is going to be better than she even was at the Rio Olympics 5 years ago, where, by the way, she won 4 Olympic gold medals there.
Yeah, unbelievable. And you know what? The problem with Simone, and this is not a problem, obviously.
I was going to say, where are you going with this?
She does the hardest gymnastics in the world, but she will make it look so easy. She is able to fly like nobody's business. It's just been a thrill for me to be around in the time of Simone Biles.
And take a look at this. Speaking of difficult, she unveiled this vault, Yurchenko double pike. Only person in the entire world to do this. She will not be doing it here tonight, but she is saving it for Tokyo, trying to play it just a little bit safe because, of course, it is pretty dangerous.
You guys are Olympic champions. You know, we got 21,000 people in here, all the people at home watching on TV. What do you feel when you get that opportunity to watch someone like Simone Biles? There is no one else like Simone Biles out here. You feel grateful, right? Just that opportunity to watch her?
Yeah, you absolutely feel grateful. And she truly is in a league of her own, and she's competing against herself. And I think that's something that impresses me so much with her. She could have just played it a little bit safe and be a lot easier for her to be able to go out there on the floor events and do her routines that she did in Rio, but she wants to be better than she ever was.
Tim, self-inflicted pressure, the type of pressure that she feels tonight?
Well, she's so good at what she does. She probably is manufacturing a little bit of it right now because she's going to feel it in Tokyo, no question.
Just absolutely spectacular, every single thing that she does. And let me just remind you, that was her quote-unquote easier vault. And again, not many people in the world even compete this vault. She goes a half on onto the table. Look at the open body position. So what makes Simone so great are obviously so many different things, but she has such a high level of difficulty, but it's also the execution, the form and the technique that she has on every single event.
Yeah, but you know what? Basically, as she was walking back, she was shaking her head, and she's not happy. She's a perfectionist. That was a bigger slide backwards than she wanted to.
Still, 9.4, the execution out of 10. And 15.4, the total for that opening vault. Overall leader after night one, and she was putting up the top numbers on vault on night one as well.
I think you can really see her power even better on this vault right here. This is called an Aminar. Watch her body rise from the table. And you know, she's so amazing. No question, she is not happy with those two landings.
Laurent and Cecile Landy, her coaches, now new coaches since the Rio Games. Well, there you go.
Yeah. She said it for us.
Yeah.
Not that we were thinking that at all, but it's the landings. That's what she's really been trying to train hard at. And of course, she nails each and every single vault in training, but when there's a little bit more of an adrenaline rush, a little more energy.
Move ahead in time a month. That's the Olympic champion in Tokyo with those two vaults, but she'll be way better there and do way harder things. They do two vaults because in the event finals, to make it to the finals, you have to do two vaults, and they'll take them and average them together. They got to be from what's called different families.
All right, over to one of the stars as well. You expect her to be on the team, Suni Lee, the 18-year-old from St. Paul, Minnesota, who has really emerged and could lock up that second automatic spot.
This is probably her biggest challenge tonight, the vault. She's got a bit of a bum ankle.
Wow. You know, I think that was better than night one. Had a little more height off the table, more rotation. Just a little bit of a leg separation on that landing, but Tim, as you mentioned, this is probably one of, as we talked about, her weaker events here.
And you know, we say weaker events, but for Team USA, like one of her other weaker events is floor exercise. She's the reigning world silver medalist on floor exercise.
Yeah, and a big reason why the floor and the vault are question marks because of that ankle, the injury, which is better, but is not entirely 100%. That Simone Biles, Suni Lee, and Jordan Chiles, the top three at the U.S. Championships a few weeks ago and on night one here in St. Louis. So just to give you a guide, as we show you the scores, green is excellent, yellow is safe, and red is below average, and all of that's based on the recent major international meets. How they compare to those around the globe. 9-2 execution at 5.4 difficulty to start with, and then 14-6. And here is Jordan Chiles, 20 years of age from Vancouver, Washington, but training in Spring, Texas, along with Simone Biles these days. And another one expected to be on that team.
And boy, can she explode off of the table. Very similar to Simone. Watch how high she flies right here. Oh, big wow. That was gorgeous.
One down, three to go, and she is well on her way to her first Olympic Games.
Yeah, you know, really everybody knows Simone Biles is going to go to the Olympic Games. This young lady right here has had so many different competitions this year, and she has been just fabulous in every single one of them. I would say that barring an injury, she is a lock along with Suni at this point in time.
You know, we talked about this pretty much all week, all weekend, both on the men's side, the women's. Really, it's so important, peaking at the right time. You know, she has been great all season long, but really throughout each competition, she has just gotten better, more confident, more consistent.
We'll try to listen in as much as possible throughout the night. Yeah, you look at the season, and that number 14.933, but the Winter Cup, the U.S. Classic, the U.S. Championships. Now here, she has been terrific, has had momentum, and has carried it through. How about Kayla DiCello, the 17-year-old from Maryland, did not have a great U.S. Championships, but has been solid here. Comes in sixth place into night two.
Yeah, and that was very uncharacteristic for her. She's a very consistent athlete. Also does the same vault we saw from Chiles.
Oh.
Yeah, she was like a different athlete at the U.S. Championships. I told her coach right there, Kelly Hill, I was so surprised by seeing her make all those errors, and she said, me too.
You know, coming in to an Olympic year when really you don't have that much competition experience, the amount of pressure and the expectations and everything else that comes along with an Olympic year.
But another thing, you know, she would have been a first year senior had the Olympics taken place when they were supposed to. You know, all the different athletes had, you know, some the postponement hurt. Morgan Hurd, who is not here, for someone like Kayla DiCello, it was a good thing.
Hey, think about Morgan Hurd not making the Olympic trial. She's won a world all-around title. And yet that Olympic cycle peaking at the right time, that not only during that individual Olympic year, but during the four-year time period.
Well, and that's what, you know, that's what we keep saying. It really is the hardest team in the world to make when you are leaving off your world.
So guys, take us through, Nastia, those names maybe in the mix.
Yeah, so taking a look at this, you have vault and floor in the combined scores. So of course at the U.S. Championships and then on the Olympic trials night one. Look at those four scores. Grace a little bit weaker on both of those events, but really for Leanne Wong and Kayla and Michaela Skinner, just right about equal.
Yeah, it's basically the same exact thing. So it's going to come down to who has the best performance tonight.
On one night of your career, it comes down to one night. So remember, there'll be six athletes there, including Jade Carey, who's earned a spot already, and then an individual spot, four team spots. Tom Forster, the high performance team coordinator, he leads the way, but it's that selection committee. They'll go behind the door, they'll crunch the numbers because it is empirical these days, and select that team.
Yeah, I definitely don't want to be in his shoes tonight.
But they're going to start with numbers, and they're going to be able to back it up without question.
All right, how about that individual spot? Could be a name like Riley McCusker, the 19-year-old from New Jersey who's in Arizona training now. This is a moment ago.
Oh, boy.
Wow.
Oh, that is heartbreaking. So she was going so aggressive there, trying to go exactly to a handstand. Risk and reward.
There she goes, repeats the skill. This is probably one of the hardest things to do when you start your bar routine in the first element. You have a fall like that.
Big combination right here. Now down to the low and back up again. Handled that great. So she has a hurt ankle and it's really been a problem. It's actually her foot has done very few dismounts. This is the only event she's doing today.
Creates a question mark now.
It absolutely does.
That individual spot, Riley McCusker, a lot of people thought, okay, makes absolute sense to take that athlete in that spot. 13-5-6-6, maybe opening the door for some others. Here in St. Louis, the greatest of all time, along with athletes who, in a few hours, will experience something that they've never experienced before and will remember the rest of their lives. Is the gateway city this week, St. Louis, path to Tokyo. And you can watch us live here on NBC or check this out, NBCOlympics.com, NBC Sports app as well. You can stream all of the individual apparatus, see what's going on in real time out there on the floor, NBCOlympics.com or the NBC Sports app to watch that way. Sam Mikulik saw him in action yesterday. Part of that Olympic team. He'll be going to Tokyo, along with Brody Malone, Shane Wiskus, and Yoel Moldauer, and Alec Yoder for the men on the individual spot. So, guys, what do you think? What do you make of what we've seen so far?
Well, it was off to a great start. Unfortunately, that mistake on bars from Riley was not only uncharacteristic, but that is that one event that you really can punch your ticket to the Olympic Games. Unfortunately, she's now going to be sitting on the edge of her seat for the rest of the competition and the selection process.
Yeah, without question.
All right, another name in the mix. I know she's in 10th after night one, but remember the needs of the team and where those are. Leanne Wong, family watching. The 17-year-old from Overland Park, Kansas, about to go. And that senior elite debut back in March of 2019, we saw, and it was one of those names that you went, oh my gosh, Leanne Wong's going to win. It was the American Cup in Greensboro. In the 2018 U.S. Junior All-Around Champ, and now at this level, trying to earn a ticket to Tokyo.
Those gorgeous lines, beautiful extended knees and toes. That was way past the handstand, though, at least 3/10 off.
Again, right on top of the bars, what the judges are looking for. That one was a little short, too.
Very good. Double layout somersault. Oh, boy. And that's unfortunate. You saw that step. It was a 3/10 step. If it's more than a meter, it's 3, less, it's 1/10 off.
All right, how about Grace McCallum, 18 years of age from Minnesota, in 5th place after the opening night. She's been on a couple of world championship teams already.
Same ball we've seen. Yurchenko, double twist.
Oh, that was great. I think that vault might have been the best that we have seen her do in a very long time. Has struggled with injuries this year. But once again, talking about peaking at the right time, this is exactly where she has been best all year long.
Nice technique. She gets her arms back to the table very quickly, gets off the table fast. That helps her get a little bit higher. And just, you see that, that's about a foot, so that should be only a 10th of a point on that landing. The judges will find a bunch of different things, though. What they're looking at, see her legs are a little bit apart, feet are a little crossed. Pretty good body position. They're gonna say her hips, her chest should have been up a little bit higher on the landing, but overall a very good ball. This is a routine also that Team USA is looking to get a better score. than Suni Lee on vault and floor exercise. And Grace is one of those athletes that can do it.
In the mix.
Yes.
For that team spot. And on vault, the number important, 9366 for execution and 14.766 overall. Go over and get the number for Lian Wong on uneven bars, 13.8. The other events very important for her the rest of the way here. Night two for the women in St. Louis. Back with a look at the 24-year-old from Arizona, Michaela Skinner, who could be on the verge of making her first Olympic team. With more on her, let's join Andrea Joyce.
Well, Terry, I think it's safe to say that Michaela could certainly be the star of a gymnastics don't ever give up campaign. Remember, she came in ninth in the all-around at Nationals and then had a meet of a lifetime first night of Olympic trials, and she is firmly back in the Olympic conversation. We all remember Michaela's heartbreak when she did not make the team, came so close in 2016, named an alternate instead, went on to a great college career, but then decided in 2019 that she had unfinished business. That comeback, however, has been filled with monumental challenges. First, a painful Achilles injury, then a scary bout with COVID in December, followed by pneumonia that put her in the hospital in January. Fighting to regain her physical stamina, Michaela told us that she felt like she had been hit by a bus after Nationals. An incredible rebound, though, here in St. Louis. And when I told Michaela that Nastia said this was the best she had ever seen her, Michaela's eyes welled up with tears, and she said, "It has been a long, long time. I just want this so bad." Terry?
You think about that journey for every athlete. It's different, and for some, that success comes right away. For others, I mean, you think about what she's been through in that career at the University of Utah, vault and floor. She's very good on this a moment ago on bars.
As she said in 2016, it was great to be able to go, but she said it was being the alternate was very, very hard, and I don't think it can really be explained. While watching, she said she knew she would try again.
Night one really was the best meet of her life. Looking for round two here. You know, I think more than anything, something that I just admire about her so much is really what Andrea was just talking about. You know, it's about not giving up, being an alternate, your first Olympic go-round, going off to college, truly just doing it for the love of the sport and the goals that she has.
And there were doubts. People said, well, you're coming back to this level after being in college. It's really unlikely you're going to make the Olympic team. And here she is, perhaps on the verge. We saw her talking a moment ago to the 21-year-old from Phoenix, Jade Carey, who is 14th coming into night two, but has wrapped up that individual spot. She's earned it. It's hers. One of two spots. And a moment ago on uneven bars.
Big release combo for her. Jade has completely transformed her gymnastics on this event. Just a ton of difficulty. She won't be doing the all around here tonight, still nursing a bit of a ankle problem. I think it's the best routine I've ever seen her do.
A lot of parents in the stands tonight. Her dad was right there. He's her coach. So a front row view of that, 13.733. You're talking about exclusive clubs. How about one with one member? The GOAT on the slipper, greatest of all time.
Golden, streaming on Peacock, which will also stream gymnastics coverage live during the Olympics. And one of the athletes featured in that documentary, one of the athletes you'll be hearing from in our Olympics coverage in Tokyo, Team Gold, Beam Silver, Lori Hernandez from 2016. Great to be back with you.
You too.
It is night two for the women, and you've been through this pressure 5 years ago of trials and Sunday night. What kind of pressure are the athletes feeling as we're watching them here?
Oh, well, day two is terrifying because you just want to make that team. We've noticed some little mistakes on bars here and there. Riley McCusker did fall in her first turn, but she got back up and made a beautiful routine. We also see that Michaela has dropped into sixth place for now, and that's bars is not her strongest event, but I wouldn't be surprised if she comes back up after the next few events.
Yeah, let's put up the standings through that now five rotations, the four from Friday and the one from tonight. And you do see that Grace McCallum and DiCello have moved up a spot. Skinner, who started the night in fourth, is down in sixth. But again, with the first two in four and five on vault and Skinner on the bars in six here, in six, you're not surprised that that's happened. What do we watch for with the uneven bars the rest of the night?
Oh, I mean, honestly, there can be a lot of little mistakes that happen because of pressure and because of nerves on bars and on beams, so we should definitely be watching out for that. But also, floor and vault seem to be a lot of these girls' strongest events, so we're just going to be, we're going to see the scoreboard kind of go on shuffle throughout the night, I think.
Right, and again, we're watching that fourth spot. It's not exactly the numbers, it's just part of the equation, but yeah, we'll keep an eye on it. Lori will be with us to help us sort things out and tell us what the athletes are going through throughout the evening. Simone Biles is moving over to those uneven bars that you talked about. Yeah. We're going to go take our seat, which is right over there. It's the best seat in the house, next to Lori in front of the uneven bars, and Simone when we come back.
Back with a reminder, after tonight's final competition, wake up with today and meet the U.S. Women's Olympic Gymnastics team when they sit down exclusively with Hoda in their first interview tomorrow morning, only on Today. You think Hoda will want to talk to Simone?
I would say she probably might want to.
Maybe one question.
Yeah. So to the second rotation of the evening and the sixth rotation overall, with the two nights coming together and those points counting on both nights. Michaela Skinner in sixth right now, lost a little ground in terms of the placement, but remember, as Mike said, she was on bars, so those who were on vault, the higher number.
Yes, much higher, actually. And for example, Michaela can get a 15 plus on vaulting, so it's going to tighten up a lot. She really has one super test in this routine, and it comes right here. She does it back with a fold, but she does it in combination. So tricky.
Ooh. A little off in that first back handspring.
Yes.
Mistakes on that at the national championships, but not here. She seems just a little bit timid, holding back just a little bit, and happens a lot when obviously the nerves are high.
It happens a lot when your dreams could possibly come true. It's just, but you know, being careful on beam is a recipe for disaster. You don't want to do that.
Just needs to get through this beam routine, and her last two events are her strongest. And really just, unfortunately, little mistakes on almost every single element, so that execution score is going to be lower than night one, but just the dismount left right here.
And gonna do a really difficult one. Full twisting double somersault. We'll see it one at a time tonight. Oh! Oh. And that was okay, she survived, but that wasn't great.
And you heard her say she was off to the side.
So this is so difficult because she does a back handspring in front of this back with a full. Take your cell phone, lay it on the floor, that's how wide that beam is.
Don't think I've ever done that. And here's that dismount, so a round off to a full twisting double back, so really, really difficult. A lot of gymnasts do this element on the floor exercise, but you see that chest down really low. Going to be a big deduction there.
All of this against the backdrop of making the team with what, yeah, it's awfully hard to watch, family members, with what she does on floor and vault. Did she get away with this here now?
Well, you know, I think when we go back to that first graphic, when we at the top of the show, the two points that had the question marks, those two events were vault and floor, and these are the two events where she is really strong. Bars and beam, Team USA pretty much has covered with Simone, Jordan, and Suni if they are able to make that team.
So a so-so number might not really hurt her that much on beam. All right, over to Jordan Childs. the 20-year-old Vancouver, Washington, on uneven bars just a moment ago.
Has a ton of releases in this routine. Great handstand position. You're looking for that on every skill. That went pretty good. Maybe a tenth off. Transition. Boy, she has just been a rock all year long. She's competed more than anyone. Wow.
Does it again. Guys, the Cardinals play down the street. Nobody's hitting 1,000 in their lineup. She is for 2021. She is 22 out of 22 in terms of routines.
I believe it's a stim. Some of them have heat as well.
Getting a little help. We'll figure it out during the break. 13-4, the number from Mikayla Skinner on beam. As we continue, night two at the Olympic team. Second rotation of the night continues here in St. Louis. Leanne Wong, the teenager from Kansas, getting set to go on beam. Take you back to the opening night, Nastia. Here's what happened.
You know, and she has been really great all season in the last few years, really, but unfortunately had two major mistakes here on the balance beam.
Yeah, she scored an 11.5. That is a brutal score.
And you know, we talk about this all the time too, but now having to try to put that routine and those two mistakes just a few days ago past her and try to focus on this beam routine where the pressure's even higher than it was night one. As physically demanding as the sport is, it's just as much, if not even more, mentally challenging.
Those were very aggressive right there. Good to see that. There we go. Oh my goodness.
Wow. I don't know how she stayed on.
Yeah, she was way to the left and then all of a sudden she wasn't. And what she did night one is not her typical. She's a great gymnast. Wanted to combine those two elements together. Because she paused too long, she'll lose just a little bit in difficulty score. There you go. Nice, love that. Remember, she had a big problem on this. Nowhere near enough rotation, had to take three bounding step forwards. It's really difficult. Round off to a triple twist.
Better than night one.
Oh, I'd say a lot better, actually. You know, I mean, it's like her coach Al Fong, longtime gymnastics coach in the United States, her teammate Kara Aker. That's pretty darn good.
Get the number in a moment. Meanwhile, Kayla DiCello, one of those names right there in the mix for the team in fifth place after five rotations, and her effort a moment ago on uneven bars. Remember, she opened up on vault, moved up in the standings.
Those 2 weeks after the national championships to really get back, reshift her focus. So many mistakes in Fort Worth at championships. Oh.
And I have seen her miss releases here, but I have not seen her miss that one here or in Fort Worth.
So that was the open to her routine on uneven bars and eventually 12.8 the number.
But remember, bars and beam are not the critical events for someone like Akayla DiCello. It's the floor and the vault where she could help Team USA get a better team score.
You know, Grace McCallum also definitely in that mix, in fourth place after the opening rotation here tonight.
Looks like a different gymnast than what she was in Fort Worth. Big combo right here, very nice. A little shy of the handstand there, that'll be a 10th. Another release.
A little short on that handstand.
Step backwards, you know, it can be a little bit better. That last handstand was probably the biggest deduction in the exercise. Coach Sarah Jancy, she has been here in the last quad. She coached Maggie Nichols, 2015 world team member and gold medalist.
And Grace recently graduating from high school, eventually going to go to the University of Utah. There's the number for Leanne Wong, and even 14 on balance beam. Patriotic shades on. Back to check out the number for Grace McCallum on even bars, and even 14, that execution, 8.2.
Better than night one.
Yep. Trying to solidify a spot, and Suni Lee should have one of those spots. The two-time U.S. all-around silver medalist.
Buckle up. This is wild. Oh.
So in action here tonight, for more on her and her journey, let's join Andrea.
Terry, when you think about everything that Suni Lee has been through the past couple of years, her composure as a competitor is really quite remarkable. Her dad's accident, battling back from a foot injury, losing a beloved aunt and uncle to COVID, and she will tell you that there is absolutely no way that she would be here tonight without the support of her family, especially her dad, John. And they did once again make the trip across the country from Minnesota, an eight-hour drive, just to be here to support her. It's worth noting that before a fall from a ladder left him paralyzed in 2019, John was the constant presence at Suni's meets while her mom was at home with her siblings. Suni says that having him back at Nationals after a three-year absence was an amazing gift. She told me that there's definitely more pressure at trials, but her dad keeps her grounded, and his pep talks really give her a jolt of energy. And I talked to John on the way into the arena, and he said the overwhelming feeling from the family is simply excitement. Terry, they've got a lot of confidence in their girl.
Such positive reinforcement throughout, too, and she's talked about it, how important her family has been and their relationship with her dad. And she's out there competing. And she was warming up, and I know you were excited already.
Well, no matter what time it is, that Suni gets on the bar, it's always exciting. But, yeah, of course, that was the warm-up. So an athlete always gets about 30 seconds on the apparatus before it is competition time, which is why she didn't finish her routine. Or if you have a mistake, it's obviously okay. But
it is a special routine, though.
It really is.
So stay tuned for that. How about Jade Carey? Yeah, just another reminder for people maybe just watching tonight for the first time, that individual spot that Jade Carey wrapped up, it was the World Apparatus Series around the globe. She took that route, wrapped up a spot for herself. There's another individual spot, and then the four team spots where they actually compete as a team in the team final. The Olympics.
So she will not be part of the team competition. Everything else, all around finals, individual event finals, she'll be representing USA, but just not in the team competition.
So a rule that, of course, the Federation of International Gymnastics implemented this Olympic cycle. Just a little wobble there, but this Olympic cycle in I don't know about you, Tim, but I certainly have not quite been a fan of the selection procedures for it.
No.
Being able to get that spot, it's been confusing. It's been challenging for all of the athletes.
They're going back. They hadn't even gotten to the Olympics yet, and they've already decided that it'll be a five-person team for both the men and the women in Paris 2024.
Of course, not to take away from what Jade has done, such an accomplishment to really be the only one here that is already on that Olympic, I guess not team, but is going to be an Olympian. Just the dismount.
Very nice.
Well, really was always so strong on vault and floor, and bars and beam were not always her two strongest events, but has really taken the last year and a half or so to focus on those to be able to compete in the all-around at the Olympics.
Yeah, she said, you know, the postponement, the extra year has been an advantage for me. I've been able to really improve balance beam and unevens.
Saw the high five from her dad, Brian, her coach, and now Shailese Jones, the 18-year-old from Westerville, Ohio, a moment ago over on balance beam.
I'll tell you what, Shailese is an absolutely stunning gymnast. So powerful, beautiful lines, all of the qualities. Look at this right here. And her first big acrobatic element, Arabian front. Oh, hold on with those toes. This is a big pass right here. Two back handsprings into, oh, she actually changed it up. A great routine. Her gymnastics is phenomenal. She does struggle with consistency. Not on this one. Love seeing it. Love it.
12th place at the U.S. Championships a few weeks ago, entering tonight. Night two, she was in eighth, 13.3, the number for Shailese Jones. Saw that effort from Jade Carey on beam, 13.4.33. Yeah, that there's not the same tension on her face as many of the other gymnasts. Yeah.
It's the Olympic trials in name only for Jade.
All right, over to uneven bars, and it is Simone Biles that focus.
And remember, she didn't, for Simone, she wasn't as great as she can be on her first event. And usually,
one part of the time in the first part, and the resistance.
Usually when she does not live up to her own standards, she can come roaring back.
Ron and Nelly, her parents, been so important in so many ways. We now have that gym down in Texas too, and great gymnasts who train there and well represented here at the Olympic trials too, a number of them. You heard that last minute little instruction from her coach. Normally, what would you get from your coach right now?
Well, you know, it's really interesting because so many athletes prefer different things, and that's what really makes a great coach, is learning your athlete, understanding what they need. Sometimes you need total silence. You need to be able to take a moment, visualize your routine, while others, as you can see, Laurent constantly talking through every little last minute detail that she needs to remember. The coach is not allowed to talk while they are on the apparatus during the competition.
Oh boy, and that does not happen. Big straddle of her legs. She kind of was a little short on the first cast to Hanson. That was great though. And now down to the low.
Back on track.
Very difficult dismount. Double twisting double.
similar look on her face as we saw after the vault.
Yeah.
In reaction.
Right before she went up on the uneven bars, you heard Laurent say, don't rush, be patient.
I want to die.
It's okay, it's okay. Good
job. Yeah, that's all that matters.
Which one? That one?
Yeah.
Let's see that
one. Good girl, good job.
Fight.
I want to die. That's a little over the top, Simone. You're still the best gymnast in the world, even when you have things like that happen.
High standards.
Yes, she absolutely does. But right there, that was the problem. She was a little short before she did this skill, which is called a Weiler. Great fight, great mental composure there. So it didn't turn into a disaster. See, she's a little under that handstand and has to pause, and it threw her timing off.
But not many gymnasts would ever be able to do that. The strength that she has in order to muscle through that skill right there is just so incredible. Pretty much every single other gymnast would have most likely fallen off the bar, had to start over. Yes, she got deduction, but she did not fall off the bar. Extremely difficult dismount, double twisting, double back. And you can just see it on her face.
Mm-hmm. Yep. And again, she's competing against herself at this point and her potential on any given night. Because there's no one even close.
Can you check this side just in case?
Okay. And you know, you also wonder what it must be like to coach Simone Biles. There's nobody at that level.
Intimidating.
Probably.
Yeah, absolutely.
But you know, the trust that she has had in her coaches and vice versa, I mean, this is the reason that she's performing these skills here and being better than she was in Rio. You know, she is doing skills that have never been done before, and she doesn't even need to do that. She doesn't need that level of difficulty in order to win the Olympic Games again.
You see the number 13833, so in yellow, we're used to seeing green for anything that Simone Biles does in terms of our indicator there. But you're right, they have many of those skills they have suggested, and at first she has said, what, are you crazy? No way, I can't do that. And eventually she does in competition. How about this routine right now for Suni Lee?
I believe this is the hardest bar routine in the world. When we saw that warm-up a little bit ago, she actually didn't do one of her main connections. She's a maestro on this event, but I tell you, this routine is so tricky.
She not only flies so high like this skill right here, look at that. But the connections, and she missed that one right there. So no deduction, but we'll lose bonus points. Everything is normally done back to back to back.
There's another set of releases in a row, back up to the high bar.
And one more right here.
That was a good choice, I tell you, her not going for that first one. It didn't look like she was in the right position. Full twisting double.
And you know, that was good. Night one, so much better because she obviously connected those elements that we were talking about. Her difficulty score was a lot greater than it's going to be here. But that's putting another check mark by it. You know, of course not. They're happy about that, obviously, staying on the bar. But look at this, the height, the hips, the open position. Right back down to the low bar, and this is, you see her toes so close to that bar. She was supposed to put her toes on the bar and then immediately go back up to the high bar.
Got back on track like she always does. The athletes do an extra swing like this. It's called a giant to generate more speed, and that can turn into more height, more power, and a better landing.
Wasn't able to do what she did on night one, but when she is, Olympic gold medal potential, right?
Oh, absolutely, without a doubt.
On that particular apparatus. So, Suni Lee, rotation two complete on night two here at the Olympic Team Trials.
Her score on the uneven bars, 14.9. That is the best of all the competitors on the uneven bars thus far tonight. And everyone has been through the uneven bars. So Suni Lee remains in second behind Simone Biles, who maintains her lead in the competition. Even though she was not satisfied with her performance on the uneven bars, her score was the fourth best of all the competitors. As you see, it remains tight, 4, 5, and 6. We continue to watch as those final spots will be decided over the next hour or so. As we have been saying throughout, Simone Biles certainly on her way to Tokyo, and in many ways even stronger competitively than when she entered the Rio Games 5 years ago. In those 5 years, Biles, now age 24, has developed and strengthened her presence in the sport, using her voice to speak out on issues important to her. It is one of several examples of athletes using their platform more than ever. Take it to the track and field trials in Oregon. St. Louis-born hammer thrower Gwendolyn Berry made Team USA last night. There was some confusion when the anthem was played with her performance there and what she was doing. We should note afterwards, Berry told our Lewis Johnson, this year has been very tough on her. She considered quitting the sport, but has continued on in part to spotlight what she calls a bigger purpose, including issues facing Black Americans, a cause she has demonstrated for in the past. While it remains to be seen how the International Olympic Committee will react to any similar demonstrations on the medal stand in Tokyo, the USOPC has permitted what it has termed respectful demonstrations throughout these Olympic trials and has said it supports athlete expression. Speaking of athletes, this reminder, the track and field trials pushed back a bit because of the oppressive heat in Eugene, Oregon, will conclude tonight at 11:30 Eastern and Central Time, 10:30 on NBCSN. It's been postponed because the temperature's reaching close to 110 degrees. We're back here in St. Louis for the final two rotations at the gymnastics trial as we continue with 21,000 on hand here in the dome.
To remind you, I will, either way. Yep, the Olympics begin July 23rd, live from Tokyo on NBC, and Simone Biles will be there. So will we, watching the gymnastics, and who's going to join Simone? We find out tonight here in St. Louis. Three other team spots available. Jade Carey's got an individual spot and one other individual spot out there to be earned as we take you out to the floor now, and Shailese Jones ready to go.
She said about the postponement, it was heartbreaking for her. I was so mentally and physically ready, I didn't know how to feel because it was out of my hands. Everything about this floor routine is stunning. Looked like just 1 foot went over the line. That's a tenth of a point. I don't believe both did. That would be 3/10.
Beautiful. Routine, difficult, and also just the flexibility and the artistry that she showed. That opening tumbling pass, you know, we always talk about going out of bounds. Not that big of a deal, of course. It's a deduction. But as you mentioned, Tim, it's 1/10 if you go out with 1 foot only. So let's take a look. Let's see where she lands. So toes on the line.
Oh, no, they're both out, but I don't know if the judges will be able to see that. So 3/10 if they did.
But once again, in the grand scheme of things, one tenth or three tenths is really not a huge deal in the sense of a fall being an entire point.
The thing I love about that routine, though, it's got amazing tumbling, and the leaps are just, I mean, gigantic. She just jumps in the air, gets huge split.
That's a
amazing routine.
Floor routine dedicated to her dad has been dealing with health issues. This is the start of rotation three. However, a key routine took place back in rotation number two, and it's Kara Aker, the 18-year-old from Green Valley, Missouri, on beam. This is where she could make the Olympics. Individual spot.
Oh my goodness. And that's not a little deduction. That, you know, a lot of swings of the arms.
You know what Kara's normally so good at on this apparatus in particular, everything just flows from one element into a dance move, into a leap, a jump. Gorgeous.
Yeah, that was great. You know, really with Riley McCusker falling on bars, it kind of opens things up potentially for Kara. She's long been known as someone who is certainly capable of getting it done on the international stage. She's a Pan Am champion on this event. 2018 World Championships in qualifying, she was second on the event to Simone Biles, had a fall in the final.
Just the dismount, there's a tumbling combination right here, round off, back handspring, 2.5 twist.
Oh, that was awesome. That was awesome, but at the top of that routine, you see that 14.566? You know, they're gonna wanna see a number that's close to 15 to be a factor in winning a medal at the Olympic Games.
Shaky start, good finish, but we'll see. We'll have to wait and see how that factors in overall in the selection committee at the end of the night. Shailese Jones, 13.533.
And so you see that penalty is only 1/10 deduction, so she got a little lucky.
Yeah, Shailese, we were wrong. We were wrong. We were dissing you.
We agree with the judges this time.
First look at Emily Lee, the 18-year-old from Los Gatos, California, San Jose area. That's where she was born. And her effort here on balance beam.
Got her start because her dad found a coupon for a free class in the newspaper. And the rest was history. That cost him a little more than that free class.
Yes.
Oh, that was fabulous. Three elements in a row.
Probably one of my favorite combinations. Each element equally as difficult just on its own. So combining the three, you have to be so precise.
Good fight there. And she does all of these elements
very slowly.
Yes.
Apparently. Little hiccup there with the video. And eventually 13.566. So we apologize for that. But 7.566 for execution. Go back to what you were talking about, though. So many athletes, gymnasts you talk to or read their bios, they got their start because when they were young kids, they were had so much energy doing somersaults, jumping off couches. The parents say, you know, we got to place this somewhere.
Becomes a little dangerous when you're doing in your living room.
Exactly.
But I would say that every single one of us that ended up in the sport of gymnastics, we did that. We did that on ballparks. We did it in the living room. We did it in the backyard.
I could see you doing that.
Yeah. The monkey bars.
Absolutely.
At recess.
Yeah, absolutely.
All right, how about Grace McCallum? What an evening. How important this is now, her effort on beam.
Very calm. Had a 13.866 on this event in day one. But at the U.S. Championships, had a 14.2 both days, which is a big number.
Was supposed to connect those three elements.
Yeah.
Once again, all of these connections, so she's not necessarily losing deduction by not connecting it, unless, of course, she has a wobble, but she will lose in the difficulty.
Oh, boy. But remember, once again, for that fourth spot, it is not going to be up to balance beam and bars. They're really going to be keying in on floor and vaulting. Nice landing. It was just okay for her. She can actually be much better.
Her final rotation will be on floor, so that will be a big routine coming up. 13-8. So Simone Biles still leads the way, and she'll be on balance beam as we continue from the U.S. Olympic Team Trials here in St. Louis. Those top three spots, pretty much how they were going into tonight, but that fourth team spot, very open, and the individual spot. So a key routine coming up for Leanne Wong. Guys, again, just to remind people going into the night how we had it.
Yeah, no, absolutely. And you see the question marks on both vaulting and floor. That's where Suni Lee could compete and the Team USA would still win. But those two events are areas where if they choose the right person, they can add on to what Team USA scores.
And this is how close it was coming in.
Oh, I mean, look at those total scores. So we combined the championship scores, which were a few weeks ago, just on vault and floor. And then, of course, night one of the Olympic trials. I mean, it is essentially right about the same. Grace, of course, a little bit lower there. But you know what? It's also a lot about consistency and being that leader of a team and trying to be a team player as well. And so a lot going into the selection.
Leanne Wong, a short time ago in this rotation on floor, a key routine.
Was a gigantic routine for Leanne Wong.
Remember, floor and vault, the two areas, the two events where they could use someone in that fourth spot. And so that number key, you still have Michaela Skinner coming up in this rotation on floor. But now over to balance beam and Simone Biles.
See a lot of the gymnasts start with this element right here, a wolf turn.
She had a little problem night one. Nobody spins faster than her on that. And when you look at it, do you think maybe you would slow down? I can't believe how fast she goes on it.
She has just complete control of every skill. First test here, three elements in a row.
And that's a champion right there, because she was off, but she didn't even have an arm wave for the judges to say, oh, she's off balance. They can't see that because they're judging. Wow. That's shocking. Actually.
Shocking for sure, but you know, it just kind of humanizes her a little bit to know that even the very best in the world sometimes have mistakes.
Don't panic, folks at home. It's not a problem. Simone Biles will be in Tokyo without any problem at all. Don't know what she's going to do for the dismount.
Just a cool twisting double back, capable of doing more. Sometimes not saying anything says it all.
Yeah, pretty sure she doesn't want to talk about it, that's for sure. No one is tougher on Simone than Simone. But this is a great example. And you mentioned this earlier. Laurent is not trying to force any conversation. He's giving her the space that she needs. A less confident coach, maybe less experienced, might be saying, it's okay, it's fine. It's Simone Biles. It's not fine for her. He knows that. She knows that.
Silence spoke the loudest there.
So again, was just... Oh, from the takeoff of that, when we're watching down the angle of the beam, she doesn't seem too off.
No,
but
yeah.
When she lands, it's yeah. Her foot, yeah. I guess, and her shoulders. And, you know, this happens a lot in training with a lot of different athletes. I'm sure not really Simone very often.
Guys, this is the night that athletes have. There are off nights, but it's just shocking to see from her because we're just used to seeing her do everything she sets out to do.
Let's look closely here again. She does dip it a little bit to one side, but you know what? For me, I don't think this is a problem at all. Sam Mikulik watching on. He can't believe it. Neither can we, neither can she. But, you know, it might be not such a bad thing for Simone Biles, you know, to maybe get a mistake out of the way. I know she doesn't.
Still in green, 13-7, guys.
Well, and it's because you see that difficulty score of that 6.5. I mean, everything that she does is so difficult. Of course, the execution, 7.2 out of a 10.0, a point off for that fall. And she's disappointed in herself. You know, she doesn't want to go into the Olympic Games with that beam routine being the last time that she competed. But again, you know, it really, truly is no big deal. She will still end these trials on top of the leaderboard.
All right, over to floor right now. How big is this routine coming up from Michaela Skinner?
As big as it comes. The next two events are Michaela Skinner's Olympic trials, floor exercise, and then she'll go to vault, the two weaker events on Team USA, and she can deliver.
24 years of age, already been to college, competed there for the University of Utah, NCAA all-around runner-up twice, and an NCAA record with a streak of 161 straight routines hit, but this is the moment. This is the stage right now.
just tons of difficulty, huge acrobatic elements. First one is a double layout with two twists. She does struggle at times with staying in bounds, so that's a key thing, and it can add up quickly. Shuffle back, and I believe both of her feet were out of bounds, so she'll lose for the steps and also 3/10.
She didn't go out of bounds there, possibly just stepping on the line. I was watching the line judge.
Yeah, the line is in gymnastics.
And by line judge, yes, that means there's a judge that literally just watches every single time they land in the corner. So here's that opening tumbling pass, two flips, two twists in a laid out position. You see her pike down a little bit, and yet her heels.
Yeah.
Are definitely out.
Both of them are out for sure. And she took a little slide, then a step, and looked like she took another step.
Well, they missed one tonight.
Yeah, they did.
So we'll see. Those moments when you're waiting for that number, and we'll get back there in a moment. But over to the balance beam now, and Jordan Childs just about ready, solidly in third. So one of those spots. Now, remember the top two, it's her parents' watch, and Team Chick, that's her nickname. But the top two spots in the all-around at the end of the night, they're absolute locks. So she still has a chance to get one of those.
I thought her mom was like yours, Nastia, and couldn't watch Beam in competitions, but.
Not just Beam, but everything. He has just been so confident. As we mentioned throughout the whole season.
Really nice start. Probably too much of a hesitation from the aerial into the leap to get a connection there, but.
You know, obviously mistakes sometimes happen, but you can really tell how the athlete is feeling from the very first skill.
Yep. And you don't see jitters right now. You see confidence and patience.
And not holding back. Capable of doing the same dismount that Simone just did, but from a round off, full twisting.
Yeah, she's gonna do it for sure. This is not easy at all. She
She's a rock star.
It didn't look easy.
Thank you.
23 for 23 in terms of routines hit this season. And guess who she's named after? Michael Jordan, number 23. Got one more to go, though. Going to surpass that, maybe.
So here's that dismount. So you see a round off in a double backflip with a full twist, so difficult. As I mentioned earlier, a lot of people do this skill on the floor, just about a stick. So chest was just a tiny bit low on the landing. Looks a little bit lower, obviously, when you slow it down. There you go, mom and dad.
What a transformation since going to World Champions Center. When she got there, Cecile Landy said that she had so little confidence, didn't believe in herself at all. They were able to get her to buy into the system. She calls the Landys, both Laurent and Cecile, the dopest people she's ever met.
Give her credit too, though. You go back a couple of years, a silver medal at the U.S. Championships was passed over in terms of the World Championships. Thought the sport had passed her by, didn't want her anymore. Had to believe in herself again after an 11th place finish at the 2018 U.S. Championships. And here she is on the verge of going to the Olympics.
One routine away.
All right, the number for Michaela Skinner, they're breaking down the numbers there, 13.5.
So yeah, I'll warm up first.
Not as good as she could have gotten, 13.866 night one.
But you see that those penalties, 3/10 off right there for stepping out of bounds on that opening tumbling pass.
Yeah, so they did catch the two out of bounds. Suni Lee, that fight for the second spot in the second lock with Jordan Chiles a moment ago on balance beam.
Wolf turn again, and she does a second one. They're able to do two of those elements as long as they aren't the same number of rotations.
That was great. This is tremendous for her. She said, because of the injuries, I feel like people kind of are doubting me. Oh, gorgeous.
No need to doubt anymore. Double full.
I hope you like long flights.
Direct flight to Tokyo, 14.733. She is ahead of Jordan Chiles, overall 13.9. Don't get me wrong, they're both going.
Oh, yeah, they absolutely.
But Suni Lee may not have to wait as the tears flow for Simone Biles. One more rotation left.
Show the world.
One final rotation left here at the U.S. Olympic Gymnastics Trials in St. Louis. You see Simone Biles leading. That's the addition of Friday's four rotations and three so far. If it was just tonight alone, she would be in third position. That is rare. Lori Hernandez, gold and silver medalist from 2016, with us again. Lori, we never see Simone make mistakes, and we've seen it, and we've seen her emotions tonight. What do you see?
Yeah, honestly, we have to remember that even though she does incredible things, she is a human being and things happen. We can tell that she took it to heart. hard. She looked a little choked up in the back. Also, she was getting her ankle taped afterwards, so nothing to cause alarm for, but definitely keep an eye out for that for Flora next, but I'm sure she's going to kill it.
You mentioned she's on floor to wrap it up. That's really the last time under the lights with a lot of people watching until Tokyo. How important is this final exercise for her?
I mean, I honestly, you know, even with the B mistake, she's still a lock in my eyes, and I'm sure to the rest of the globe, but floor is important, just I think for her own well-being to know that, okay, I made a mistake, but I'm going to go and I'm going to show up anyways. And, you know, I think everybody's excited to see that.
There's pressure, and it's rare to see her show some of that pressure is real.
Yeah.
And we've seen that so far. We'll see what happens. It's also a very big floor exercise to start this final rotation in terms of figuring out the team that will go to Tokyo along with Simone Biles. That's coming up as we continue on this final night of the Olympic trials from St. Louis.
So, down to the final rotation. Grace McCallum, one of those names in the mix for that fourth and final team spot.
Oh boy. Oh boy. That is a gigantic deduction. Those are 3/10 steps and both feet out of bounds. Close to a point off right there. Mm.
Not exactly the routine that she wanted to end her Olympic trials with.
Oh, yeah, that was disappointing. You know, she has been battling so many different things, had a boxer's fracture in her hand, a plate and 7 screws inserted, was really behind in preparation time. She told us that she definitely was much better between U.S. championships and now, but here's this double twisting, double somersault, and you know what? Athletes love to have extra juice for floor, but that is so much extra juice. Both feet out.
Way out.
Yeah.
You think about those names in the mix for the team spot. Grace McCallum on floor there. Still have Kayla DiCello on floor, and then over on vault, Leanne Wong and Michaela Skinner.
And you know, Terry, they don't specify how they're going to look at the USA's and the Olympic trials, but they're certainly going to have the inclination to think that the trials are more important because they're closer to the games.
But they both count, the numbers go into all those computer formats and files that they put together. We'll see how big this is now for Michaela Skinner on vault.
She can get 15 plus. She needs probably the vault of her life right here.
Just about to say, one of the most important vaults of her life right here.
Believe she's going to do the Chang first. Has a 16-0 maximum score. And it was very good. No question, the only thing she could have done better was put both feet down and don't move them. That was a 3/10 step for sure, but Nasi, what did you think? I thought the body position was pretty good.
I thought it was great. You know, I think that's something that she does so well. on this event right here. So a half onto the vault, and you see just a tiny bit of form right off of the table, tiny bit of a pike down in that step, of course, but really has made significant improvements on this vault over the last few years. In the past, really almost didn't complete that half turn. Once again, that pike down just a little bit.
Yeah.
The judges are looking for the complete open.
And the irony, yes, if she had kept that open, she would have been in a better position to stick it. Big number, though.
Now, the final thing that Michaela Skinner will do tonight that she can control, then it is wait.
This is an Aminar, same as we saw from Simone Biles.
Wow. Mm. You know what? No matter what happens with the selection process, the emotion says it all.
Spent your entire career, your entire life to get to this night. And now it's a waiting game.
Awesome.
How many times, Nastia, do you go to bed at night and you lay there and you envision this moment and that time when you make an Olympic team? Did she do enough?
Just sad. Ask me.
Sister, husband, everybody with tears up there.
Well, it was a wonderful journey. And it wasn't easy for Michaela Skinner. She has overcome so many different things.
And now it is up to the other athletes still to come and eventually that selection committee behind closed doors. 15-2, the number. Got the crowd going before those vaults. This final rotation wanted them up loud here inside the dome. They were. Now we wait to see. Mississippi and the Gateway Arch here in St. Louis. This is where you earn your ticket to Tokyo if you are one of the top gymnasts in the U.S. It's all on the line tonight in this final rotation. So back to that number for Grace McCallum on floor, 13.5, guys.
Yeah, it's not a bad number, and a 13.8 would have been so much better if she had just been able to hang in bounds.
So Simone Biles, it's been that rare night when Simone Biles, the greatest ever, has not brought her A game to this stage. But she's got one event left on floor.
Yeah, you know, she didn't win the gold on beam in Rio, had to settle for silver because she grabbed the beam, but I cannot remember the last time I saw her come off the beam.
This is going to be a huge first. Opening tumbling pass, it's called the Biles. Triple twisting, double back. Here it goes.
Spectacular, one step, one tenth out of bounds. Makes that look too easy, way too easy.
And the second Biles right here.
Was supposed to connect into a leap, so she'll lose a little bit there, and also another tenth out of bounds.
Thank you.
without a doubt, the greatest of all time, even with a bad day. But she is absolutely going to Tokyo. And for those of you that are worried, is she not as dominant?
Hey,
no worry at all.
They're not worried. Everybody on their feet inside the dome in appreciation.
Standing ovation. The impact that she makes here out on the floor is just tremendous.
She'll be the first to tell you she wasn't at her best tonight for much of the night, but even less than her best, it's pretty special to watch.
Absolutely. She's so great that even with a fall off balance beam in Tokyo, she's standing on the top rung. Unbelievable. No other female athlete has ever done this. There's only a handful of men. That is two flips with three twists, and oh, is that hard.
Here's that second tumbling pass, a double layout with a half turn, and the reason why, of course, both of these called the bio, so you see her step out of bounds there, no big deal, but she was the first athlete to perform both of those elements at a World Championships or an Olympic Games, and that is how you get an element named after you in the code of points. But that ending pass right there, a lot of people can't even do at the beginning of their floor routine, and she's ending her routine with a double twisting double back.
Tears, hand on heart.
The reason she's got a green is because it's Simone Biles, and she's got a 6.6 difficulty score.
I know.
Very cool moment. Everybody on their feet here in appreciation for what she's done, who she is, and what she's going to do at the Olympics. Suni Lee out there on floor now.
Frequent flyer number, because you are Tokyo bound, Suni Lee.
There you go. So we'll see that second spot. Remember, it's a lock. Whoever gets there, Suni Lee or Jordan Chiles, they're going either way. We still have Leon Wong to go on vault and Kayla DiCello on floor. That fourth spot on the U.S. Olympic team at stake here tonight in St. Louis. Simone Biles leading the way. Ended up on floor here tonight. Last event for her in these Olympic team trials. Looking ahead toward Tokyo. Okay, Suni Lee, 13.933, trying to wrap up that second spot.
Yeah, that's a big number.
And that should do it.
Yes, I would say so.
And remember, the top two spots are automatic locks. Now, Jordan Chiles is going to go to the Olympics. Needs better than 15.4 change here to take that second spot. And overall, guys, it's only one night, but Suni Lee had a higher number tonight than Simone Biles.
Yeah, that's unthinkable.
Mm-hmm.
You got to finish a routine here, Jordan. Come on now. Very emotional, obviously. You can't, Nasi, you really can't even sum it up, right? You can't even say how important it is.
There's no feelings really to describe exactly the amount of pressure that she's feeling right now, that she's just putting on herself to finish this competition the best possible way that she can and lock a spot on the Olympic team. Jordan, do the same thing that you always do every single day. First Olympic Games.
Just a couple of years removed from thinking about quitting the sport, thinking the sport didn't want her, it had passed her by. And here she is wrapping up a spot at the Olympic Games.
So glad you saw it through. What a wonderful athlete.
Simone Biles, Suni Lee, Jordan Chiles, those three. You saw that embrace from Simone. And look, every athlete's got to put in the work. Do it yourself. It comes down to you. But Simone has been so instrumental in leadership, in bringing her down to Texas to train. The atmosphere there in the gym, conducive to getting to this moment right now. Pretty cool. So 14-2-3-3. And into third place behind Suni Lee overall with Simone Biles at the top. All right, Kayla DiCello now. How important is this floor routine?
Well, it's really important because, once again, they're still looking for that perfect person that brings the most potential team score on floor exercise and vaulting. She had a very nice start on vault. She hasn't had a great competition beyond that, but this is the one that matters most.
Almost the same exact thing that we saw from Grace do a little bit earlier in the rotation.
Both feet out, 3/10 plus the step.
A great finish, but you know that she is just going back to that routine earlier this competition. But as you mentioned, Tim, you know that is not exactly where
on that first pass, huh? Lots of energy. I love energy. Good job. I'm proud of you. Now we wait. Okay, it was great efforts today.
But it's not exactly where she needed to excel on the uneven bars. It was really about vault and floor. Unfortunately, that first tumbling pass. This is probably going to be the hardest moment now. The competition finishing.
All right,
waiting.
We started the night talking about those names in the mix for the fourth team spot. Kayla DiCello, Grace McCallum, Michaela Skinner, and Leanne Wong comes down to the final rotation and everything on the line with the vault.
Just about as good as she can do.
So the number 14.7, that execution 19.3. How do you split them? How do you really?
Nice shades.
just crunching the numbers here, which they're going to do behind closed doors, the selection committee, over the two nights of trials on vault and floor. Skinner is ahead of Leanne Wong by about 2/10 of a point. It could come down to that. We'll see. Kayla DiCello, 13.5 for the effort on floor.
Yeah, good, but it could have been better. She needed it to be a little better.
All right, so closing out this final rotation, and Emily Lee set to go on floor. Excuse me. Malabuyo on floor. We got Emma Malabuyo and Emily Lee still to come to close out this rotation. Malabuyo in eighth after the seventh rotation. 18-year-old from California.
gorgeous routine. A great Olympic trials, was fourth at the U.S. Gymnastics Championships a few weeks ago. Has dealt with so many obstacles, injury after injury. Was one of the top kids. Oh, boy.
Came in with hopes, guys, because of that fourth place finish at the U.S. Championships.
World champion.
By the way.
In the all-around Kim Zanesco.
I'm watching Nastia Lukin the entire evening and fighting back tears for much of it.
Not even fighting back. They just happen. You know, it's a night like this that no matter the outcome, these are the moments that you will remember for the rest of your life.
I hope they're soaking it in because it doesn't get better, folks.
Everything that these athletes and truly the entire world has gone through in the last year, the postponement of the Olympic Games. So many athletes, I guarantee you, probably every single athlete here at one point questioned, is it worth me to continue training? Is it worth it to keep going one extra year and for them to all be here competing?
Yeah, one extra year with the amount of work that they put in. That, I mean, they're working out 40 hours a week every day. You know, they're not taking days off. They don't go on family vacations.
You know, no matter if you've competed at the Olympic trials or not, we will never truly understand what all of these athletes have gone through in this last year.
It's a great point because, I mean, it doesn't compare. We're talking sports here and adversity in sports, not life. So many people dealt with such tragedy though over the past year. But in terms of sports, to have to do it again for an entire year, and it comes down to this night, the final athlete out there, Emily Lee.
Boy. Yeah, that's she can't finish it after that. That was a really bad landing.
Trainers over medical personnel. So a standing ovation for Emily Lee as she has helped off the floor. I hate to see that and it end that way. 18-year-old high school graduate this year and the final one here in this final rotation of the Olympic trials. So Simone Biles obviously wrapping up a spot. Suni Lee in second place wrapping up a spot. You know, Jordan Childs is going to be there. And then it comes down to the selection committee. And look, it's not official for Jordan Childs. I know.
No.
I understand it's the top two. It's Biles and Suni Lee. However,
it's as official as it can be without being official.
I just want to qualify it. That's all.
No, absolutely.
Per the selection procedures.
but after that, I mean, we're going to take some time here and we'll have the time because they'll go behind closed doors, and it'll take a bit of time to make those selections. But those athletes in the mix wondering right now, I mean, this has got to be excruciating to think, did I do enough?
You know, these next few moments for every single person except Simone and Suni and pretty much Jordan and Jade, who of course has also already locked in a spot to the Olympic Games. This is going to be the toughest moment, just having to sit there and wait.
And there's also the specialist spot that needs to be named, and really the main contenders there are Riley McCusker, who had a fall today, Kara Aker, who could have been better than she was today.
We might be biased, but you know, I think gymnastics obviously being one of the toughest sports, and any single one of these athletes here competing at the Olympic trials could truly be out on that floor at the Olympic Games. And it comes down to, so many times it comes down to who can perform their best in the moment that it counts.
But you wonder right now, if you are those names, whether you did. You know, here's the odd thing. Normally right now, you know. It's a competition.
Absolutely.
And they don't know. So the top two are locked. Simone Biles, Suni Lee, as we send it over to Andrea.
Well, Terry, at the end of the day, an incredible accomplishment, a second consecutive Olympic team. Simone, a standing ovation. The crowd went wild for you at the end of this competition. What were your emotions when it all ended?
I feel like I've been emotional this whole week. I just can't believe Olympic Trials is here again. I can't believe I'm here again. It's been, the journey has been so real. 5 years later, and we're doing it again.
You have spoiled the world with year after year after year,
right,
jaw-dropping, spectacular gymnastics. We know you weren't happy after that beam. What were your thoughts?
I was just really upset. Everybody out here came, gave their heart, and I just didn't give my best performance. So that was what I was most upset about.
So we're going to switch gears and move forward now.
Yes.
In 2016, you were just a teenager, and everybody joked about how Allie Raceman was the grandma of the team. You are the leader now. What does that mean to you?
I am. I'm old. I feel like I have a lot of wisdom. I can guide them through the meets. I've been here before, so I just want to keep everybody cool, calm, and collected.
All right. Well, congratulations. And Suni, we know that these past couple of years have not been easy for you. What does this mean to you to be able to be called an Olympian?
This means so much to me. I've worked so hard for the past couple of years, and to just go out on the floor and do everything that I was supposed to do feels amazing.
Your whole family drove out here 8 hours from Minnesota, including your dad. How much has he inspired you?
He's inspired me so much. Whenever I look at him, I just kind of like make myself do better, I guess. He motivates me a lot. And to be here with him means a lot to me and all of our family.
So you had said that this year, though, that it was very difficult to fight off the negative thoughts and the sadness. What was it that powered you through?
I think just thinking about this moment right here, making the Olympic team at the Olympic trials, and then just of course thinking of my dad, because he's done so much for me, I want to give back.
All right, well, congratulations to you both, and we'll sit on pins and needles as we await the announcement of the rest of the team. Terry?
Thank you.
Thank you.
All right, congratulations to both of them and the families here watching. So special. And John has certainly gone through a lot, and the whole family has, Ms. Suni Lee, and here she is, going to go to Tokyo and compete at the Olympics along with the greatest of all time, Simone Biles. Not bad. Who will join them? That's the question. Selection committee behind closed doors. They're going to crunch the numbers, make that decision. We'll see who will represent the United States after a night of emotion here in St. Louis at the Olympic team trials. Stay with us. We'll find out in a bit here.
Simone, how would you define the word greatness?
The greatest of all time.
I feel like I would describe it as reaching the pinnacle of whatever you might want to do.
Ever since I was a little girl, I've always wanted to make the Olympic team.
This has been my dream since I knew what the Olympics were.
That dream is real for every athlete out on the floor tonight.
Wow! Watch out, Tokyo.
That was fabulous.
Knowing how close I am, that motivates me every day.
I've been working for it for my entire life.
wouldn't be here without my family and my dad.
I made that beam out of a 4x4. You're half the size as you are now.
Jordan Chiles, she has been a rock star.
As a father, you just kind of look and you say, wow, that's my kid. She went from this 7-year-old flipping around.
I like the gymnastics.
To being this elite gymnast.
It's not easy. They've had to make sacrifices just as I have.
Mom and dad, excited for their daughter.
Grace McCallum, one of those rising stars.
She's so much she can overcome. I think she has proven a lot.
Hey, Michaela.
It's been a lifelong dream of hers.
You know, for her to make the team, it would be everything.
That's the best routine I've seen Michaela Skinner do ever.
There are so many talented girls.
We have more gymnasts to fill a team than most countries have.
And the most dominant team in the world right here.
It's going to be really nerve-wracking at that point.
Who's it going to be? It could be this, it could be this.
These are the moments that you are going to remember for the rest of your life.
And the moments are taking a long time for the athletes and their parents, the parents of Jordan Chiles. They've got to feel quite confident that their daughter will be on the team. You saw Michaela Skinner's parents in that feature. Chris and Kim also kind of waiting and hoping that their daughter will be one of the members of Team USA. Leanne Wong's parents as well, watching and wondering those individual apparatus spots as well, as we now do the wait to see who will be on Team USA. Once again, rejoined by Lori Hernandez, who was on the team in 2016, part of the gold medal winning team. So Terry made the point to Nastya that she was fighting tears throughout the evening and the emotion of the night. For you sitting here and now being at this moment as the team is being put together, I'm sure it's emotional as well.
Yeah, I think it's still pretty fresh. You know, I've been on the side where my name got picked and I was able to be a part of the team, and now I'm on the side where I got injured and this is just not my time. So I have empathy for both sides. This is very nerve-wracking and heartbreaking. So it is what it is.
The night as a whole, Simone Biles wasn't the Simone Biles we've seen over and over and over. But there were other great performances. Suni Lee under pressure, Jordan Chiles under pressure. As you watch them perform, what are your feelings about watching those two athletes as they've probably earned their way to Tokyo with what they've done at trials and U.S. championships before?
I mean, they have absolutely earned their way. These girls have worked so hard. And I mean, we only see what's out here, but you know, behind the gym, all the hours in the back, they have worked so hard and they definitely deserve this.
You know, I see the emotion with you, and we realize it's 11 years for the athletes, the parents too. And one of the things that I've noticed traveling around to these trials, the parents can't come to Tokyo because of the international ban, because of the pandemic and COVID-19. So for the parents, this is the last time to see them and their children perform in person.
Yeah.
That's part of the story, the athlete-parent connection and how much they mean to getting them to this spot at trials and beyond.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, my parents had everything to do with me coming back. They had everything to do with my journey, my family, my inner circle. So I can only imagine, you know, on the outside, what these parents are feeling watching their kid, not knowing what's going to happen. My dad said he was going to have a stroke watching me. So, you know, there's just a lot happening. It's because we care.
And we'll have the members of Team USA and all of that emotion that will come with that coming up in a little bit. I can only imagine what it's like back in the room there as the athletes walk back. There were tears. We'll have tears of a different sort probably in a little bit once we know everyone on Team USA. What a night. It's not over yet. The bottom line still to be written here in St. Louis.
Back in St. Louis as we continue to wait to find out who will be joining Simone Biles and Suni Lee on that Olympic team traveling to Tokyo. And check out the life-size Olympic rings, by the way. NBC's sending them around the country. Fans can pose with them ahead of the Tokyo Olympics. Rings across America kicking off next week. L.A., Chicago, Miami, Orlando, and Washington, D.C. You can pose with those, take some pictures. Skinner family. Cellos. I mean, it's just got to be excruciating. Terry Gannon back with Nastya Lukin and Tim Daggett. Guys, as we look at the parents, Mike made a great point. You can't travel to Tokyo. This is it. They're in attendance tonight. As parents, you're used to being there for your kid out there competing, and tonight's the last time you can do that this year.
Yeah, and that's tough. You know, I think every single parent is feeling that no matter the outcome, they have poured their whole entire lives into this one moment, and they are just crossing their fingers,
that the outcome is going to be exactly what they all want. And not being able to be in Tokyo as well is just heartbreaking, to be able to support your child the entire way and not be there. But of course, rules are rules, and they'll support them either way.
Hey, Tim, let's break it down now. Those four in the mix.
Yeah, and if you look at this, if you take the four competitions, two at championships, two at the Olympic trials on floor exercise and vaulting, the person that impacts the team score most favorably is Leanne Wong. And it is very, very close beyond that. They'll look at other things as well. They'll look at the all-around placement, because you have to remember, they're going to travel to Tokyo, and it's possible somebody could get sick, somebody could get injured, you know, so they're going to look at a lot of different things.
And they will look at that, but just look at Michaela Skinner, that number for the Olympic trials, that second level there, 57.765. So that's the highest just in this event.
And you know, that's what we talked about really all night long, was peaking at the right time. So when you look at those two scores, she has done a tremendous job at truly training this entire year to peak right in this moment.
And I really believe that, you know, they're going to look at four competitions, but they're also going to look at the most recent competition. They're going to look at dropping the lowest score from the four competitions of each athlete. They'll do all those scenarios.
That's a lot to be done.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, you're talking about, and we're told they're getting very close. So it's happening quickly. And, of course, they've run this through the computers many times, the scenarios, what might happen if this happens or that happens. And we do want to point out, Lili Leung, who's the president CEO, is not in that room of USA Gymnastics. She's not part of the selection committee. There she is right now. And the fact is that it is empirical. They will have numbers to at least back up what they choose to do.
Absolutely. It's a three-person selection committee, and they're crunching the numbers, that's for sure.
I'm going to put you on the spot. You're going to hate me right now.
You
really, you're going to hate me, but what would your pick be?
You know, it is so hard. You know, I want to say Michaela Skinner, because she's her trajectory right now is going in the right direction.
Okay.
But, you know, Leanne Wong, if you look at the numbers from all of the competitions, you know, USA, it doesn't matter who goes. They are going to come home with the Olympic gold medal.
But I can tell you one thing, for these athletes that are sitting in a room waiting for their destiny right now, it is the hardest moment of their life.
And maybe even harder for the parents sitting in this big room, the dome here at America's Center right now, waiting to find out who will be named for the Olympic team. So we continue to wait. Countdown has begun. Keep you posted. Stay with us. Back with a look at Shannon Miller, Amanda Borden, both winning gold after the Magnificent Seven, part of that group in Atlanta. 1996 being announced here inside the dome as we continue to wait, but we are told, Tom Forster, they have made the selections, going over to inform the athletes, the makeup of that team to join this legacy. I mean, just read down the list. Two straight Olympic gold medals in the team, four straight Olympic golds. Yes, I see the name Nastia Lukin. Seven straight world all-around titles. And Simone Biles obviously has not lost an all-around meet since 2013. So Terry, Nasty, and Tim back here inside the dome. And it's that legacy they'll have to hold up in Tokyo, be a part of that, and will be the overwhelming favorites.
Oh, they will, absolutely. There's no question about it. Any team with Simone Biles on it is going to be the favorite. She is just so dominant, and she has a supporting cast that are phenomenal. Suni Lee on uneven bars, it's like watching magic. It's poetry on the uneven bars. So many great gymnasts.
There's pressure there, too.
Absolutely. But I said it at the top of the show. You know, this is the hardest team in the world to make. And no matter who is on this team, every single athlete here competing at the Olympic trials has so much to be proud of. To be able to be competing on the floor here tonight at the Olympic trials, they are the best of the best in the most dominant country in the world.
So we'll find out very soon. Won't be long now, Mike.
Not at all, Terry. Nastia is part of that legacy. You just showed the dominance of American women's gymnastics. Laura, you were part of that 2016. How much blessing, how much burden is that to have to continue the legacy of everyone who's come before you?
Listen, the Olympics and gymnastics, it's generational. It just keeps progressing. And honestly, these girls have worked so hard and their names are going to be remembered forever. It does feel like a lot of pressure, but at the same time, you all become a family. And it's like you just have even more respect for those that came before you.
After the team gets named, there's team camp. What is that for a coming together of the entire group?
Yeah, you know, when you come to competitions like championships and trials, you represent your home gym, the gym that you start up from or wherever you're at. But when you start coming to trials and you go to the Olympics, you're representing the United States and you become a unit. It's awesome.
And that's happening right down that hallway. We'll find out the names on Team USA for Gymnastics. Those were supposed to be the last names for trials winners for the U.S. Olympic team, but the track and field trials in Eugene, Oregon were pushed back because of excessive and record heat. So 11:30 Eastern, 10:30 Central on NBCSN, we'll have the live conclusion of the U.S. track and field trials, including Noah Lyles trying to make the team in the 200 meters and Dalil Muhammad and Sydney McLaughlin in the 400 hurdles for the ladies. When we come back, the naming of the U.S. Olympic gymnastics.
We are only 26 days away from the opening ceremony of the 2020 Tokyo Olympic Games. Athletes train their whole lives for the chance to compete in the Olympic Games. It is a dream, a hard-fought fight, the hope of many, but the reality of few. For these athletes, the road to Tokyo starts now. Here to present for the first time your women's artistic gymnastics Olympic team for Tokyo 2020, please welcome a legendary member of Team USA, a two-time Olympian with 7 Olympic medals, 2 of them gold, a two-time world all-around champion, and USA Gymnastics Hall of Famer. Please join us in welcoming Team USA's most decorated Olympic gymnast, Shannon Miller.
Please welcome the 4 members of the 2020 Tokyo Olympic team. Simone Biles. Sunisa Lee. Jordan Childs. Grace McCallum. Representing Team USA in the additional National Organizing Committee quota place, please welcome Michaela Skinner. Representing Team USA in the additional nominative quota place earned through the individual event World Cup Series, pending FIG confirmation, please welcome Jade Carey. Please congratulate the replacement athletes who will travel with Team USA to Tokyo. Kayla DiCello, Kara Aker, Leanne Wong, Emma Malabayo.
Ladies and gentlemen, let's hear it for your women's gymnastics Team USA. Joining these Team USA Women's Artistic Gymnasts now, please welcome back the men of Team USA for Artistic Gymnastics. your Team USA for rhythmic gymnastics. And your Team USA for trampoline. Tokyo 2020 Olympic gymnast for Team USA!
So the celebrations underway already out there on the floor. Bring you back here and let's talk about this now. Simone Biles, Suni Lee, Jordan Chiles. Those were the names throughout the two nights. You said, okay, pretty much locks. It's Grace McCallum who will take that fourth team spot. Jade Carey had a spot already wrapped up. It's her own spot. And then Michaela Skinner is the other individual spot. I'll start with you, Nastya, get your reaction to this. I know it's an emotional moment right now.
I'm not sure if I have too many reactions besides the emotion. I mean, just looking at this right here, seeing this combined Team USA going to the Olympic Games after everything that they have faced throughout this last year. And, you know, I think maybe there have been some surprises, but at the end of the day, everybody has so much to be proud of. Tim, you mentioned, we've mentioned this all weekend long. They are the best country in the entire world, the most dominant, and it is just so incredible to see those faces out on that floor.
Tim, it was that fourth spot. We didn't know what they were going to do with. Grace McCallum picks up that fourth team spot.
I know. I'm still not quite sure what they did. I mean, she's a great champion. She's been on the last two world championship teams. She's typically very consistent. She hasn't been so consistent this year, but she's battled a lot of different injuries. She's a great teammate, there's no question about it, but I really thought that they were going to look at some other things a little bit more closely.
So Michaela Skinner, that other individual spot, if you're Kayla DiCello, if you're Leanne Wong right now, you've been on that side. You know what that's like.
Yeah, being on both sides of it, you know, making obviously an Olympic team and then being on the other side and not making an Olympic team, it's the emotions are just, you're full of emotions on either side, but I know every single one of those athletes has so much to be proud of, and as they go on to their way to representing Team USA, it's going to be the greatest time of their life.
So the party continues. I think Andrea is somewhere out there. Where are you, Andrea?
I am. I'm up on the floor here. This is quite a celebration here. Jordan, congratulations. Couple of years ago, you talked about quitting gymnastics.
Yes.
Can you tell us what's going on in your heart and in your mind right now?
Honestly, I'm going through so many emotions right now. I 2018, I did not want to do this sport, but all the love and support that I got from everybody definitely encouraged me to continue, and look where I am now. I'm happy and excited, and I can't wait to see what happens.
Well, you had your teammate and your best friend Simone in tears at the end of this competition, and Grace, you've always talked about being in the zone. Tell us what's going on in your zone right now.
I'm just so excited. I feel super blessed and honored, and it's just amazing. I can't thank my family and friends enough for all their love and support throughout the years.
Michaela, you have been here before. 2016, it didn't turn out your way. Take us through the last hour, what it was like, the wait, and hearing your name called.
It was super emotional. hey, Mom!
intense, especially going back to 2016. So I was definitely just trying to have positive vibes. And when Tom came walking through the room, I was like, maybe the team, maybe the individual. I was hoping one of the two, and it finally happened. So all my hard work has paid off. So thank you to everybody. You've been amazing. I love you all.
Congratulations. We will see you all in Tokyo.
Thank you.
Andrea, thank you. So we wrap things up here, and guys, what a night of emotion. And you've been there, you have felt it, and you know exactly how they feel right now, both of you.
Absolutely. And, you know, they are, as I mentioned, they're about to... can't even control themselves anymore. The emotion takes over. They are about to embark on the most memorable experience of their entire lives.
Celebrate this moment. Celebrate it with a giant exclamation mark. You're all Olympians. Awesome.
And then get back to work. The team's been selected, Mike.
Terry Nostia, Tim, thank you. They are all Olympians and Olympians for life. I'm reminded of what I heard a couple of weeks ago from some of the swimmers at the swimming trials in Omaha. This may be harder than the Olympic Games for many of these athletes, and we have seen the emotion of that throughout the weekend and tonight. And there's more of that. Remember, the track and field trials were pushed back a bit because of excessive heat in Eugene, Oregon. So 11:30 Eastern, 10:30 Central on NBCSN, the conclusion of the track and field trials, including the 200 meters with Noah Lyles trying to make Team USA. Don't forget, tomorrow morning on Today, Hoda Kotb will have the first interview with the U.S. Women's Gymnastics team. Coming up next for most of you, it is your local news. Oh, and we are 3 weeks and 5 days from the